All right, good afternoon, everyone. Today is on Monday, July 20th, 2020. Welcome to the fifth meeting of the Senate Standing Committee on Corporations, Authorities, and Commissions for this year. I'm State Senator Leroy Comrie. We are joined by the ranking member, Senator Phil Boyle, and Senator Gonardis is here as well. We also have voting sheets from all of the other members of the committee, which includes Senator Mayer, Senator Skoufis, Senator Ramos, and Senator Ranzenhofer. We are ready to transact the committee business. I first want to say that hope you and yours are staying safe and well during these unprecedented times, and please wear a mask in public. We're ready to begin the consideration of bills. I'll ask Chris LaBarge to read the bills. And because we have a quorum present. The first bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 6491B by Senator Gorin.
Senate Bill 6491B by Senator Gorin, an act to amend the public authorities law in relation to establishing the North Shore Water Authority.
All right. This bill would permit the creation of the North Shore Water Authority servicing Nassau County. I want to congratulate Senator Gorin for his tireless efforts to bring this bill forward and protect the water quality and fiscal health of his constituents. For years, the for-profit water has engaged in unpredictable and irregular pricing of water among different villages of the county, and this unique situation requires this action. Are there any questions and comments on this bill?
Yes, Chairman, I just have a quick question. I know now we're voting on the B print, is that right, or is this an A print?
This is the B print.
Can I just find out, I got it relatively recently. Can I find out the difference between the A and the B, what changes were made?
Yes.
Senator, so in the B print, we changed at the request of Trials Association. We made the statute of limitations for any actions against the authority in cases of injuries or death occurred by the employees of the authority to 1 year and 90 days, which is consistent with all the other authorities. So we just made the technical change and made that statute consistent with what every other authority had.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay. All right, any other questions or comments on this? Good. Can I get a motion to move the bill? Senator Gonardis is indicating. I'll second. All in favor? We have 6 ayes recorded and 1 without rec from Senator Ramos. All right. The second bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 8084A by Senator Funke.
Senate Bill 8084A by Senator Funke, an act to amend Chapter 672 of the laws of 1993, amending the public authorities law relating to the construction and financing of facilities for certain public libraries in relation to including the Victor Farmington Library.
This local bill allows the Victor Farmington Library and Ontario County to receive dormitory authority money, DASNY financial assistance for their capital projects. It is similar to other bills that have passed through this committee over the years with unanimous support. Any questions or comments on this bill? Motion to move it.
Motion made.
Moved and seconded by Gonardis and Boyle. Again, I have a count of 6 yeses and 1 without yes without recommendation from Senator Ramos. So this bill is passed and reported to the Rules Committee. On the next bill that we have on our agenda is Senate Bill 8757 by myself.
Senate Bill 8757 by Chair Comrie, an act to amend the New York State Medical Care Facilities Finance Agency Act in relation to the ability to issue certain bonds and notes.
Right. This is a DASNY departmental bill, the Dormitory Authority, that raises their bond cap for hospital and nursing home projects from $16.6 billion to $17.4 billion. This funding flexibility will be used to help hospitals, nursing homes, and other related facilities respond to COVID and proactively prepare for future public health emergencies. Any comments or questions on this bill? Motion to move the bill? Moved and seconded. We have seven yeses recorded on this bill. This bill is passed and reported to the Rules Committee. The fourth and final bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 8781 by myself.
Senate Bill 8781 by Chair Comrie, an act in relation to requiring certain provisions be included in any procurement or agreement prior to disposing of any asset owned, leased, or otherwise controlled, or in the immediate vicinity of the Lefferts Boulevard Bridge.
Great. This is a local priority bill requiring the MTA to offer current longstanding businesses at the bridge the right of first refusal to return to their business post rehabilitation of the structure. In addition, the MTA is required to honor current footprint and scope requirements during the rehab process to support the historical landmark. This legislation is strongly supported by the local and community civic groups. Any questions or comments on this bill?
Move the bill.
Move the bill. All in favor? We have a six yeses, one AWR from Senator Ramos. So this bill is passed and reported to the Rules Committee. And unless there's any other questions or comments or concerns, we have now completed this fifth meeting of the Corporations Committee. Thank you all for attending. Hopefully see you in person sometime soon. Take care, everybody. Stay safe.